Hello, wonderful people. Welcome back again to Anointed Lady TV, the home of news and politics. And we drop news every day and we also react to every videos that comes our way. If it is your first time in this channel, you are highly welcome. Thank you so much for stopping by. And if you are returning subscribers, we appreciate you for your massive support. And we say may God richly bless you all for supporting this channel. And if you haven't subscribed, please kindly smash on the subscribe button. Put on the bell so you get to know anytime we drop a new video. I have a video to present to you this very moment, and I will be watching that video with you. And after watching, let's drop our opinion constructively at the comment section. Like our videos and also share our videos if possible. Bye for now.
From where?
Beijing.
From Magu, Beijing. Anyway, Zike. You based on the local community there?
Yes, sir.
What do you do for a living?
I'm a businessman.
What kind of business?
I sell food stuff.
You sell food stuff?
I sell food.
Food?
Yeah.
At where?
At Agribeji.
At Agribeji. You have a shop?
Yes, sir.
That you sell food?
Yes, sir.
So if I take you to Agribeji now, you show me a shop, you have a sell food?
Yes, sir.
And people come here to buy food?
Yes, sir.
Eh. Yeah. Okay. What are you holding like that? Raise it up, let me see. What are you holding like that?
Gun.
Mm-hmm. You constructed it as a gun, eh?
Yeah.
So you use it to snatch things from people.
Yes, sir.
So when you point it at somebody, the person will become afraid and you collect his or her property.
Yes, sir.
Eh? What is this? This is a playfire. Where did you get it from?
We get it from church.
You stole it from church? Which
we
church?
We stole it from Catholic Church, Agribeji.
Catholic Church, Agribeji. You stole that playfire. What do you want to do with it? Eh?
Want to sell it.
You want to sell it? To who?
Any interested customer.
Okay, any interested customer. Ah. Okay, what of this? This one? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 hands. Where did you get them? Talk to me.
From
where did you get them?
From people's house.
Which people?
Students.
You mean the students?
Yes.
Eh. So you went to their house. Okay, you snatch the phone from them. Eh?
Yes, sir.
Stand up. Okay. You went there and started collecting the phone from them one by one.
Yes, sir.
What did you tell them when you got to the house?
We told them to submit their phone.
You and who?
Me and my colleague.
Who is that person? His name?
Chimwe.
Chimwe who? You don't know his surname. From where?
Obukpa,
in the Sokoto local government. Is he living in Agribeji?
He's living in Ogute.
Ogute here. Yeah. So he's at large. So two of you went to the house. So yes. What did you tell them when you got to the house?
We tell them to bring their phone.
You told them to submit their phone to you?
Yes.
Forcefully, or did you just beg them to dash your phone, or just force them to submit?
We force them to submit.
You force them to submit. Yes. How did you force them? With what? Talk to me.
With this thing.
Okay, with this artificial gun. Yes, fake gun. Okay, you point it at them. Eh?
Yes, sir.
And tell them to submit the phone.
Yes, sir.
And they submitted it.
Yes,
sir. Is it true?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Eh? Yes. People did not even know that it is not a ray gun.
He was pointing a touchlight on us.
Eh?
He was pointing touchlight on us.
With this fake gun?
Yes.
Eh?
Yes.
So people don't know the gun is fake?
Yes.
Okay, assuming you know it is fake, what have you done?
How do we know it's fake? We could have started making call.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. With that small hammer. Okay. You are from where?
Alago.
What of you?
Alago
too.
Umeda.
Agibeji.
Umobulo.
Agibeji.
Iyonu.
Iyonu.
Ipamodo.
You see? These are our sisters now. They are from anywhere. Eh? They are right. You plan writing your work exams?
Yes, sir.
Eh. Okay, now you see that we have recovered the phone and you arrested the criminal. How do you see it? How do you feel?
We feel happy because he even told us to leave the yard and he don't even want to see us in that community again, not in the school.
Okay, after collecting the phone.
The phone, yes.
He told people to pack your things and go.
And put the community that he don't want to see us again.
In that community?
In that community.
So I will not write your exam,
maybe? Yes.
Hey, what a mess.
That we should leave our yard for them.
Which means the yard belongs to them now.
That is what he's saying. Maybe.
Did you tell your parents of all this incident?
Yes, sir.
What did they say?
They said okay. They even came to Agibeji today. So after speaking with the teacher, the teacher said that we have to come here with you. So they said that we should go. Some of them don't know. We came here around 5 o'clock a.m. 5 o'clock a.m. we are here. We haven't eaten.
Okay, now, apart from this thing that happened now, what are the challenges you are facing in Agibeji? Is there another problem?
Like, we are facing a lot of challenges because at times, even when we plan to write exam, like yesterday, we plan to write exam inside the school. Somebody from nowhere was claiming to be an instant security member. Why he is not? We are the person that chased him out of the place in order to write this exam.
Thank you. Okay. Any other problem?
No.
Okay. Your exams remains now?
Yes, sir.
Don't worry. We'll be deploying our security men there.
Okay.
The end of the exam.
Thank you,
we'll give you our phone number, the phone number of the commander, the 2IC, the patrol leader. So anyway, if you discover any abnormality, you just put us on call.
Okay. Eh?
No problem. Raise that your gun now. Demonstrate how we use it. Demonstrate it. You are facing me. Why not face another person?
We want to state that Venerable Amaechi Okosa, sorry for mentioning his name, is not part of this team. He is a staff of the governor, so whatever he tells you is representing the interest of the governor and his personal opinion. When we talk about marginalization, you see it well demonstrated that the clergymen of Diocese of the Niger have been here for more than 3 hours to see the governor, and they locked the number 10 gates against, and we see people entering the government house and coming out, that they could not give respect to the clergymen and get clergymen of this status outside the gate, not even second gate, not even the last gate. Express, that is where they kept the clergymen that are not with arms, that say we want to see our governor. So there is no hall in the government house. There is no canopy in the government house. There is no place where they can ask us to come and sit down and know why we are here. And for 3 hours or more, 4 hours now, they did not dim it fit and kept us under the sun. Because, and well, you see, it's just for you to see the level of marginalization that is taking place in Anambra State. Look at the things we are presenting. Bishop Prada Memorial Primary School belongs to the Anglican Church. That the governor must stop disrupting our church services. Thoughts. We are there for up to 2 Sundays, beating our members. Thoughts, not even thoughts. How will government use thoughts against the people of his state? Religious politics. You sign something, you receive a form to sign in Anambra State, and they will request you to note your denomination before they will give you job. It's not government property. Bishop Prada is not government property. They should stop marginalization. But there is no problem. Since we are not worthy to see the governor, we are waiting. We will wait. Let it be on record that we waited till the end of the day. If he doesn't have time today, let him. Tomorrow is another day.
We don't know what will happen.
We don't know. And let them know that tomorrow is prayer rally. We don't know what will happen. But let them know that it is better for them to open the gate, allow us in, give us seat, and listen to us. But if he has closed the gate and continue, no problem, we will wait. And God will go and speak for us.
Amen. Amen.